like, comment, and subscribe.
Let's Talk Jinx, a weekly Jinx video we do every Wednesday about anything to do with Jinx, as well as this video acting as a weekly discussion thread on the Jinx subreddit, our League of Jinx. Make sure to go check that out. And it's patch day, so we're going to be talking about patch 10.22, changes to Jinx, changes that might affect Jinx in terms of other AD carry changes, something of an AD carry tier list around the video out, and of course your own opinions on the things that are happening. And one of the things to note about this patch is there is a change to Jinx. Now granted, it's kind of a clarity, kind of adjustment change in there, but it still counts, and so that's where we're going to be starting the video off today, in which case it's going to be Jinx. The E now deals all damage up front, and we talked about this last week on the Jinx subreddit as well as this channel. It's basically just a clarity tweak. Maybe you can appreciate the damage being all up front instead of burn damage being over a second and a half. It can just be all instantaneous. So if the burn damage was like an extra 200 damage, instead of it being over a time, it's just all straight up. It's a bit more bursty. It probably feels better. No one's probably going to be playing like AP Jinx, but that's probably going to even feel even better on that for burst damage. But even just with regular crit Jinx, the whole entire combo damage will be all up front more. So maybe in lane, people will be a little bit more afraid of you when you kind of land your combo, especially with a hard engaged support, I would imagine, like a Blitzcrank or a Leona or something. The damage basically being all up front with those kind of a champions, maybe that just scares some people, depending on your elo or stuff, like, oh hey, this is all instantaneous, that's kind of worrisome. Maybe not, and you know, it's not, you know, anything but just a clarity change, in which case, I'll take a clarity change. There was a quote, basically, I think it was by August, matter of fact, a long time ago. You know, Jinx has the quote, rules are made to be broken like buildings and people. Well, there was also a follow-up quote that's rules are meant to be broken, like buildings and people, but never clarity, not clarity. So there we go, I'll take it. I believe when it comes to AD carry changes too, and just changes in general, always, by the way, at the top of the patch, they started doing this if you're ever on the patch notes yourself, so you can kind of see all the champions that are being changed up here too, in case you're going alphabetical or something like that. Obviously, honorable mention to Seraphine, that will be hitting the patch at some point. The skins will be hitting the patch on the 29th. This video should be going up on the 28th as I'm recording it, on the night of the 27th and editing it. So there we go. But in terms of other AD carries, before that, let's talk about Annie for a bit, because the E now provides a shield instead of damage reduction. The shield can now be cast on target ally champions, the shield animation's been updated, the cost and range has been increased, and the shield always applies to Tibbers when he's summoned, which is something you could always do, but basically they're making it so you can put the shield on allies, and so a lot of people have been talking about, does this bring back support Annie? Annie support, the last time I really remember her being a thing, outside of the occasional solo queue game that is, it was like season 5, and I don't think this brings her back into pro play, especially because we're kind of in the pro play, right? The World's Finals is coming up this weekend as it is, and then maybe we'll get some Kespa Cup stuff out of Korea for a bit, but maybe All-Stars in December, but we're probably not going to be seeing much pro play until January once again, which is wild to think about on a side note, that pro play, they're going to be down for maybe like 2 months max, and then they got to be kind of right back into the thick of the fire. But speaking of fire, the thing about Annie's shield is it did give damage reduction when you would proc it, and then you could proc it on Tibbers as well. Now it's automatically on Tibbers, and you can cast it on an ally. So if you were playing Annie support, you kind of put it on an ally. That could probably feel a bit good. Even if you're playing Annie mid, though, it probably feels a little bit good to be able to have that option to be able to put a shield on your ally. Kind of like maybe like an Orianna or something, right? But Annie can have a bit more combo damage. Kind of like an Orianna, you want to go for the ultimate plays and stuff like that. And this is maybe like another layer to add to Annie to maybe make her utility a bit more better in team fights and team compositions. And you might be playing against Annie as well as having support Annie's on your team as a Jinx, which is why we're talking about this. So however you play the Annie like support matchup, whether you're playing as Jinx or against one, make sure to keep that in mind. Ashe, meanwhile, the W arrows now increase per rank up. So basically, as it is on live, at all ranks when Ashe fires her volley, it's always 9 arrows when they fire out. Now it starts at 7 arrows, but it gets up to 11 arrows, and I'm not sure off the top of my head if this will also increase the arc range, like the width of how wide the arrows go as they get higher, but if it does, that can be interesting in a team fight, and even in laning phase. For laning phase, I believe a lot of Ashes still, they put some points in the W, but I think they max the Q first. I could be wrong about that, by the way. It's been a minute since I played Ashe, especially at all elos, so I definitely don't know the proper answer for that. But in lane phase, if you're playing against an Ashe, just users beware. This might make some people change that max, right? Like, maybe they want the Q max for that, but maybe they want the poke damage, depending on the meta especially, and they want to actually max this first. And of course, just because, you know, it has more arrows in it, hitting you and the support more often, still being able to hit minions with it to help them with last hitting, so that we don't have to feel like, do I trade or last hit? I can just do both, because by rank, especially 7 and 9, you'll have the extra arrow on there. I don't know if it's going to be that significant. My job is just to kind of try to reach for all these scenarios that you might have to worry about, you might not have to worry about, so just keep that in mind. So it might be a Q-max, and you won't really have to worry about this until out of laning phase, but in lane phase, just if you see more arrows come out, they max that first, and you need to be wary of the arc range. I'm imagining that's what it means, so there you go. More bang for their buck, as they say. Brand is in here too, but it feels like it's a lot of mid lane Brand changes, like the opposite of Annie, where Annie's changes felt like it could be more support Annie changes, but that could still benefit mid because of utility. These ones feel a lot like they want to have Brand be able to mid lane again, like the R, for example, but just in case they're playing against support Brand, he can now bounce the R off of himself. Because we've all been there. Maybe we've been playing in ARAM. We wanted to warm up real quick and check our ping to make sure before we go into rank that our ping wasn't wild randomly for some random reason that the internet was just being spiky, and it never has been usually, but it is tonight, and so fortunately went in ARAM first and found that out. But we've been playing Brand. We got Brand somehow instead of Tryndamere Quinn, which is what ARAM loves to give everybody. And we have that moment where we could ult, but there's no one to bounce the ultimate off of. So guess what? Brand can now bounce that back off of himself now. So if there's enemy champions, Brand, any valid target, bounce. So you can just bounce it back and forth off of you. It's like Fiddlesticks before he was reworked. When he would throw his crows, if the crows didn't have anything else to bounce off of, they bounce off the enemy and then back to Fiddlesticks, and he can just bounce them back to the enemy over and over. It basically increases his 1v1 potential, because when you have that R, you might hold it sometimes because you want that juicy multi-man ultimate, but sometimes you also could get a kill if maybe you could have that 1v1 potential. So that's what I mean by it comes bound to mid lane Brand possibly getting some love more so than support. But if you have support Brand, just know if he's going in for that R, he could be being really selfish, because they actually allow him to be a bit selfish now. So that's going to be an interesting change to talk about. We talked about Jinx a bit already. Let's keep going. Let's see what other AD carries are supports. I guess Lulu, the Q base damage is decreased later. It's for top Lulu. It kind of makes right out the gate, it kind of says top Lulu. It's also increased later or decreased later. So in lane phase, it probably won't matter all that much. Samira's base attack damage and armor are being reduced from 59 to 57. And the armor is going from 28 to 26. Because Samira, so we kind of made her mark as a powerhouse AD carry who could effortlessly slash, dash, bash, and crash into a snowbally lead. We're pulling out some of her early sprawling power to reduce her reliability. I feel like they've kind of nerfed her a couple of times already, and they keep nerfing her. She's not quite a Philios level, because they're not like a whole paragraphs of nerfs going on, though. So maybe she's almost in a spot they want her to be at. She does feel like a bully. Like, in my experience so far, she does feel like she's a good lane bully AD carry. Of course, people have been talking about like the Katarina of AD carries as well. If you get those rank ups and the combos, you can kind of do some work in there. I feel crit Samira's a bit better than Lethality Samira. I know some people experiment with that, but when it comes to the ultimate, I think I like crit better on the champion. But yeah, the champion does do quite a bit of different things, and that's especially because I didn't realize until I started playing Samira myself. The ultimate doesn't have a cooldown, it just has a cost. So you can keep using it if you keep getting S ranks in the middle of a team fight and just keep popping that off. It'll just cost you 50 mana every time. It's kind of like Kog'Maw's in that regard, where the more you use it, the more mana it costs, except for Samira, it's not the more you use it, the more it costs. Just like you could spam it and kind of drain your mana pull pretty quickly. So if they want to hit Samira in the future, if you are looking at this with me and you're like, that's not enough, I feel like that's what they should hit next, is just make each subsequent ultimate maybe cost more, or just hit her mana pool, so that way she can't ult as much and maybe feels a bit more like she has to really play around good ultimates instead of just having the ultimate and ulting because it's up. That's just my thoughts. This isn't really a Samira video, so we won't go too much into that, but I feel like that would be the next step if she's still a bit too strong without necessarily gutting her, because I do think there are some things you can start to do against her now with reduced armor and things like that. So we'll see. We'll see. I could be wrong. With Xayah, the base attack speed growth is being decreased. The current marksman ecosystem hasn't been suited well for this marks bird. We're buffing up her ability to let her feathers fly. So the base attack speed growth is being increased, meaning that it's going from, it looks like 3.3% to 3.9%, not quite a full 4%, but I believe that's per level, right? That's going to be a pretty interesting change with the attack speed that they're already building and things like that. I don't really see a lot of Zyras around in terms of the olden days, especially before Kai'Sa. But yeah, even so, I don't really see a lot of Xayah at the moment, so I guess she could use a little bit of some loving in that regards, more than probably Rakan can give her. And there is a Zed in there. The E-base damage is reduced later. I guess it's a Zed nerf for those people that just really love anytime Zed is nerfed in any capacity whatsoever. Not quite a hobbling that some people might adore, but, you know, there is that. There's some Clash updates. Does anyone play Clash, by the way? Just kind of curious. I don't really play Clash. I don't know what the hype about Clash really is, but not because I think it's stupid. It's just because it just doesn't really appeal to me. But if anyone does, you know, hit me up. Yeah, not hit me up, but, like, you know, in the comments. Do you play Jinx in Clash? How does Jinx feel in an environment where the team is kind of coordinated, possibly? Stuff like that. And of course, honorable mentions to the KDA all-out skins coming out. You got Ahri, Seraphine, Evelynn, Kai'Sa, Akali, and the Prestige Edition for Kai'Sa. And there you go. So those skins will be hitting on the 29th, so people will probably be playing these champions. One of those champions is an AD carry in the form of Kai'Sa, who is getting the Prestige Edition, which, if it's like the other KDA skins, all of them are getting Prestige Editions of these skins, except maybe Seraphine, because she's getting the Ultimate skin. So, you know, there we go. So that's probably all for this video, because that's really all for these patch notes. What do you think of the Jinx change? What do you think of the AD carry changes? What do you think of all the other changes whatsoever, period, across the patch? As we head out the spoopy month and get ready for the November, where we're finally getting colder, do you think all these changes are really heating up for a really fiery preseason? But that's all from this video from me. So thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification, the actual subscribe button. But I don't know which video will be next, because life can have a lot of kinks. So until next time, take care. GG, get jinxed. Thank you for watching, and enjoy pizza responsibly.